Hello, and my name is Litefoot. My name is Chief Eagle Advisor, he is coming. My name is Shining Light in the Night. My name is Turtle. My name is Star. My name, from my mother's people that I was born to this earth for, is Obsidian Tongue. I am of the principal people, I am Wolf Clan. I am that warrior clan. I am of those who are tied to the mother, but mostly, I am of the creator.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please.
That travelistic funk.
This is something for my people. Deeper and deeper I keep digging. Wonder if anybody's even listening, cause it's getting...
Down today, she had a sheik, Timory, Velasquez, Gonzé, and that this, then she's sister, Tanya Marie, Tanya Barahana, and we're both from White Mountain Apache Rez.
And you're here in California?
I live here in Gardena, and we saw his van, so I like him traveling out here.
Uh-huh.
It's nice to have him out here.
So you said what happened when you saw the truck?
We almost got like two accidents following this. And we're like, oh yeah, about time somebody
the
comes out here.
And the Litefoot and the
made
Rez.
Us feel proud.
That's love right there. It's gonna be big, man.
He's starred in movies like Mortal Kombat 2 and Indian in the Cupboard. Well, now a Native American actor and rapper is taking a serious message to youth around the country. Mary Kim Titlis spent the day with Litefoot talking about his reach for the Rez Tour.
Then we have our living quarters.
Actor and rapper Litefoot enjoys talking about the tour bus he designed, complete with a built-in audio and video booth. This will be his home for 5 years. Litefoot, his wife Carmen, son Quana, and a crew of 10 are traveling around the country as part of the Reach the Rez Tour.
You know, you gotta look up to a man who's done what he's done. You know, it's just, he's been through a lot. Put his career on hold just to raise up natives to be warriors of tomorrow. If only a few people listen to his message and go out and tries to be influential and follow their heart and the creator, who knows what will happen. Get more native kids out there believing in themselves and being proud of who they are. And, you know, whoa. I work with the youth every day, that's my job. And, you know, I believe, yeah, the kids do need something else that people can't give them, and that's love from another power, and that's the creator.
His goal? To encourage Native American youth to stay away from drugs and alcohol and become positive role models.
To encourage them to pray, to encourage them to the Creator, to encourage them to understand that they themselves have been put on this earth for a purpose.
A message he promotes through rap music.
Listen.
There are 500 tribes in the U.S., each with different belief systems, which is why he won't promote any one religion. Encouraging young people to pray, he says, points them in the right direction.
Because it truly indeed is everything that you need. It's where you will begin to find your purpose, what you've been put here on this earth to do. And it will then become what it is that sustains you as you move forward on that trail, that path, that journey to do what it is you've been put here on this earth to do. And then you'll understand, nobody can stop you but you.
When I hear people talk about their alcoholism, talk about their drugs, how sometimes it's hard to get over that, or how sometimes it just kind of rules you. And basically, when I hear those people say that way, I know those people don't know the Creator. And if they do know the Creator, they don't know the power of the Creator. Because you can't ever convince me that drug or that alcohol is greater than the Creator.
I'm an alcoholic, and he's going to tell you something that's going to help all of us. I'm an alcoholic, and you know what? I can't help myself.
Yes, you can.
Help us.
Yes, you can.
Listen to us.
drugs and alcohol and mainly nothing to do. Mostly today's native youth do not know who they really are as far as any of us are concerned. They read the textbooks and they say, well, they see the white man's point of view and they try to use that point of view, but the Indian lifestyle and livelihood has never been really brought out to true life.
His list of sponsors is impressive, mostly gaming tribes, their logos clearly painted on his caravan of vehicles. In return, he gives free concerts. His nonprofit effort isn't fully paid for, but he says the war on drugs isn't waiting.
And that's why we're going to 211 reservations, to stand up against the unrighteousness, the negativity, the meth, the drugs, the gangs, the ignorance, the abuse, everything that it is that our people have suffered through for years. And all we do today is talk about it instead of getting up and going out there and doing something about it. So we've come here today to let you know there is a better way, and you have the power to make it happen.
Put your ones up in the air. As long as I'm praying for you and y'all praying for me, put your two up. Put them up. We ain't never gonna be apart, CrossFit.
I would like to say to you young people that the words he's been saying about do not do anything to disrupt your minds, to the clear minds that you have to have for our future.
His words are different. They're the same as a preacher's, but they're not. They mean a more meaningful way to me since I'm a young person. A preacher speaks from a Bible, but you speak about a life that's around me that I can understand better.
Like she was saying, a preacher, he speaks from the Bible and he knows stuff that Lightfoot knows, but Lightfoot says it in a way that younger people could understand. And he gives examples from what he's experienced and it makes us understand it even more.
It made me cry. I cried like almost the whole show because he was so right. And it's like, I need to wake up and I need to quit dreaming and quit sleeping and, you know, quit not taking action for anything. And this is my chance and I'm waking up.
We say it 1,500 times. You've heard it quite a bit. But I know you heard it from him tonight. Yawako.
He was put here for a purpose. He understands that. And that the Creator has allowed him to go out in the Indian world and really relay that message. And I can't think of anyone that could do that and that can take on that responsibility more than Lightfoot. He is he's an inspiration not only to the youth but people like me. In a way, he's my mentor without him knowing it, because I draw a lot of strength from him on the things that he does. He has a lot of strength about him. You know, there's reasons that each of us are placed in this world, and I believe that he's just fulfilling what was his reason for being in this world.
They're out there for their people, for all people. And we just pray that more will take heed to the messages that he has for everybody, because he's one of a kind.